Are you forever tired, constantly checking over your shoulder, deleting your VODs, deleting your clips, just to make sure you don't get the DMCA notice? Now, while getting a DMCA notice live is an extremely rare case, most of these notices are given out while you're offline due to some sort of clip, snippet, or something of your stream, or something with licensed music on, making it to the World Wide Web. Well, that is exactly what we're solving today. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video on the YouTube channel today. And as mentioned in the intro, we are solving the whole DMCA drama. Now, every year, this sort of cycle always comes around and big streamers and big content creators always getting DMCA notices in their email inboxes certain periods of the year, causing all the people below them kind of to shake in their boots. So if you're a streamer, a content creator, and you use music in your background, in your lobbies, anything like that, this video is for you today. I do want to say that before we get into the video, I would appreciate if you drop a like on the video. It would mean a lot. Hit the sub button and ring the bell to get notified when I upload videos. Now, if you have absolutely no idea what I'm talking about, here's a short little explainer for you. So let's have music artist A. Music artist A gets signed to record label A. Music artist A and record label agree on making one album signed to the exclusive deal just to their label. Music artist A asks for their salary in advance so they can pay for their studio time, any instrumentalists they need to hire, mixing and mastering, and so on. Now, once music artist A has created their album, the label helps them promote it, and the label and the creator get paid per stream, download, and so on. Now, you're probably thinking as a creator, how does all of this, you know, come back to me and DMCA? Well, when you play that music in your car to your friends or in your headphones on the way to the gym, that's fine. You have a license. You've paid for Spotify, Apple Music, you're listening through YouTube, YouTube Premium, whatever it may be. There is a license, they are getting paid for what you are listening to. To rebroadcast their music to mass audiences, whether it be one viewer on your stream or 100,000 viewers on your stream, you have to have a license and you have to apply for these and pay a very, very large fee. Record labels have their eyes on obviously the big creators because that's where most of the money is made and lost due to restreaming their music through their streams, content, or wherever it may be. So the problem that we're going to be addressing today is you're going to be able to stream with music in the background, but in your VODs, in your clips that you make later, in your YouTube videos that you take from your stream, the music won't be there. But don't fear, for anyone watching the live stream live in real time, the music will be there so you can still vibe out with your audience and still have a good time. Now, I do want to give a shout out to a few artists that I do know who are independent, meaning they are not signed to a big major label, meaning that people like you and I are able to use their music without any punishment. These artists include AJ Tracy, KSI, JME. I'm sure there's a whole load of people. There will be a Spotify link in the description if you do want to check it out, a playlist that Zerka HD has made, which is all copyright free music. Like I said, I'm sure there are plenty of artists out there who are independent. It's just there are a few at the top of my head. But unfortunately for the other 99% of the music that you listen to, most of those artists are signed to a major record label, meaning that they don't actually own the music and you can't restream it or rebroadcast it. Now, this video that you're watching right now is a direct link to one of my previous videos I made where you can pretty much emulate a GoXLR through software on OBS so you can have all of your audio sources individually so you can apply filters, do whatever you want to them individually. They're not going to be multiple and combined sources. So what you want to do is hit in the top corner. I think it's going to appear here. Hit in the top corner, watch that video, get that all set up, then come back to this video and then follow this through. So once you have all of that set up, the most important source for us today is your audio source, whether it be Spotify, Apple Music, iTunes, whatever you use. So on your OBS, on the audio source itself, again, this is where your music comes from. You want to hit the cog on the bottom next to the speaker. Now, here's a little OBS tip for you. If you want to switch to the vertical layout, all you have to do is right click in the blank area of the audio mixer, click on vertical layout, and that's it. And once you've clicked the cog, you want to head to advanced audio properties from the menu that shows up, and you'll get this big table of all your audio sources. Now, you're going to scroll to the right, and on your audio source, you're going to untick the box that says 2 underneath the tracks column. Next, you're going to head to the global settings of your OBS, go to output, make sure advanced mode is enabled. And under the streaming and recording tab, you want to tick Twitch VOD track number 2 and recording audio track number 2. So just a little explanation on what we've done here. We're telling Twitch's VOD service, so when you live stream straight to Twitch, that it's not going to hold the audio track for number 2, which is obviously where your music is going to. Again, your music will be able to listen to live, but in your recordings and your VODs, they won't be there. So now if you stream and record locally, your music will not be in your recordings. So this gives you the freedom to clip whatever you want, snip whatever you want, upload it to TikTok, make a short of it, upload it to Twitter. You won't be looking over your back to make sure you don't get a DMCA notice for it. Now, obviously, do be warned that this is not going to make you fully DMCA proof. They are still watching and snooping on everyone, so just watch out for that. but this is going to lessen the chance while you're live to, you know, get slapped the DMCA notice around the face. So I hope you find this guide useful. I hope it really stops the fear of you getting DMCA'd for you. You can enjoy recording offline with your friends a bit more. You can enjoy your streams a bit more, knowing that you have music in your lobby, your downtime, whatever it may be. You're not going to have to be watching over your back 24/7. If you did find the guide useful, I would really appreciate if you drop a sub on the channel and hit the bell notification icon to get notified when I upload a video. I would also appreciate it if you drop by my Twitch channel, drop a follow on that, say what's up to me, the community, and also links to all my social medias, my Twitter, Instagram, all of that is going to be linked down below. Feel free to check it out. My Discord link is below also, so if you want to check that out also, feel free to join me, my community. If you have questions on this video, if you couldn't get it set up properly, feel free to join it and I'll try my best to help you. Feel free to check all those links out in the description. That's all from me in today's video, and hopefully I'll catch you in the next one. Take care. Peace.